It was only just light on Sydney's last Olympic morning when the modern pentathletes began their 10-hour day. Kate Allenby didn't shoot quite as well as she'd hoped, finishing 12th overall, while Stephanie Cook was consistently accurate to rank 8th behind winner Emily Duriel of the USA. But it was a reasonable start for the British pair. Next up was fencing, 23 bouts to be faced in a two-hour period. And Cook, the 28-year-old Scottish-born doctor, started shakily but recovered well to remain in contention. Allenby fenced very well, leading at one point, but finally happy to settle for a move up to third in the overall rankings. Suvorova of Russia led, Duriel second, Allenby in the bronze medal position. In the pool, Stephanie Cook improved her personal best for the 200-metre swim by almost 2 seconds, narrowing the gap between her and the leading group. Kate Allenby also swam well. She made up ground on the Russian Suvorova and now lay second, with the show jumping next to come, one of the British pair's strengths.
This ride is really going to sort out the pentathletes this afternoon. No one can tell what will happen, but we're well placed in two events, for two events to go, which we're strong at.
And those events took place in the baseball stadium, the 16,000 crowd, including an increasingly optimistic British contingent. Allenby was first to go and was looking good approaching the final fences. That one goes down, 60 penalty points. She'd prefer not to have any more, just to keep in touch with the two Americans. Now the triple. Well done. One to come. The Sydney Opera House, the final fence. She's over, and that's a very good ride. It's within the time limit, and Kate Allenby is delighted. Meantime, Suvorova's chances were disappearing as quickly as it took her allocated horse to refuse twice early on. The Russian completed the course, but it had cost her too many points. Stephanie Cook, who knew that she would make up ground in the run, had to give herself a chance with a good round in the show jumping. Now the triple. Hit it, but it stayed on. Last fence, it's a tricky one. Oh, and it's gone. That's a shame, because 30 would have been the best ride so far in this modern pentathlon, but she'll certainly take 60, and with the run to come, her great strength, Stephanie Cook too is in with a chance of a medal for Britain. So here's how it looked going into the final run and chase. First across the line would win the gold, and Emily Duriel had a 5-second start on Allenby. Stephanie Cook had a massive 49-second handicap, but quickly set about cutting it back. So the two British women are now together. It's Allenby and Cook. Cook has already made up the 44-second lead that Kate Allenby had on her. The question is, can they get to the American Duriel? Kate Allenby, it looks as if she may have to settle for bronze, unless she can conjure up a big sprint finish, but it certainly at this stage looks like Stephanie Cook offers Britain's best chance of the gold. And Cook is definitely getting to her. What a run this would be by Stephanie Cook. 8th in the shooting, 18th in the fencing. A good swim, beat her personal best by nearly 2 seconds. That was better than expected. Then a very good show jumping round. She was 8th there. And Stephanie Cook is going to take the lead, to the delight of the British fans in the baseball stadium. Stephanie Cook is going for gold. Can Duriel come back to her? Stephanie Cook, 28 years old. A doctor, researching vascular surgery, taking time out to be a full-time modern pentathlete. And she looks at this moment very, very good for gold. Coming round the final bend, Duriel took a 5-second advantage over Allenby and a 49-second advantage over Cook. But Cook has whittled it back. She's now overtaking the slower runners. She's coming round. This is for the gold medal. Duriel for silver, Kate Allenby for bronze. It has been a memorable Olympic Games in so many ways here in Sydney, and it's another gold for Great Britain. What a run by Stephanie Cook. We were told she was the best runner in the sport. We were told the 49 seconds was not impossible. She has proved it, and Kate Allenby has taken bronze.
What a wonderful reception from all the people that have supported you over the years.
Fantastic, absolutely fantastic. I can never even hope to kind of thank everybody who's contributed to this in one way or another. I'm just lost for words. I can't believe it.
You gave up your career as a doctor to concentrate on coming to the Olympics, and you've got yourself a medal.
I just never dreamed that it could you'll be like this. I just can't believe it. It just means everything. Everyone out there was so fantastic today. I'd just like to thank everybody. They were so supportive. They didn't turn up to the shoot, which was great. And then they just were so fantastic all day. And I can't believe that we did it.
A final golden celebration. And the climax to a quite wonderful Olympic Games for Great Britain. Gold for Stephanie Cook and bronze for Kate Allenby.